go again. Once more, our Earth will have a second moon for a couple of months, a new natural satellite. Occasionally, an asteroid from more or less remote areas of our solar system approaches Earth on its journey and gets captured for a short period. This is what has happened to 2024 PT5, the rather unromantic name of the small moon of the Earth, which entered our planet's area of interest on September 29th and accompany it for a couple of months until November 25th. No need to worry, it won't crash into our planet. The laws of celestial mechanics are very clear, and this small, rocky body, just a few meters in diameter, has no chance of falling on our heads. An extraordinary event? According to the media, it seems so. Almost everyone is excitedly saying, Earth now has two moons. But is it really so? Let's find out together. As widely known, asteroids are remnants of the long process that made the formation of our solar system possible, starting 4.5 billion years ago. Thanks to the gravity exerted by the Sun, dust and rocks present in a large portion of space began to aggregate and unite, forming protoplanets. Some of these continued to accumulate material, eventually becoming the planets we know today, while others remained small due to Jupiter's perturbative action, which prevented their aggregation, or they fragmented further by colliding with each other. Most of the objects resulting from this kind of war that lasted billions of years maintain stable and relatively regular orbits in the so-called main belt, a large portion of space between Mars and Jupiter. However, many others were expelled and dispersed into the inner solar system, often settling into orbits around the Sun that could intersect Earth's. These are the so-called NEOs, or near-Earth objects, numerous, more than 30,000 cataloged so far, and especially very, very dangerous for the future safety of our planet. Identifying them and precisely calculating their orbits has become an absolute priority, so much so that various projects worldwide are currently dedicated to the continuous monitoring of NEOs, both to update their position in space and to discover new ones. Among the most important is ATLAS, Asteroid Terrestrial Impact Last Alert System, an alert system developed by the University of Hawaii and funded by NASA, consisting of four telescopes, two in Hawaii, one in Chile, and one in South Africa, that automatically scan the entire sky multiple times each night in search of moving objects. It was ATLAS that discovered the beautiful comet we admired this autumn, and it was also ATLAS that on August 7th found the small asteroid 2024 PT5 we are talking about. What the media are enthusiastically calling Earth's second moon these days is an object that, according to the data collected so far, should have a maximum diameter of 11 meters and should belong to the Arjuna asteroids group, a subgroup of the Apollo asteroids. The classification is still a bit confused, whose main characteristic is to orbit the Sun in a manner similar to Earth's. Given its size, 2024 PT5 cannot be observed with the naked eye or small telescopes, but observing it with more powerful instruments will allow us to understand more about this type of asteroid, and especially about gravitational interactions with our planet and the Sun. The question everyone is asking is, can we consider 2024 PT5 as the second moon of Earth? In general, any celestial body that orbits a planet stably and identifiably can be considered a moon. But here's the issue. Has the small asteroid been captured by Earth's gravitational field? Even if briefly, will it complete closed orbits around our planet? To these questions, we must answer no. At most, an object like 2024 PT5 can be identified as a temporary natural satellite if it completes at least one full orbit around the planet before returning to orbit the Sun. If it doesn't complete a full orbit, many prefer the term temporarily captured flyby. And we must say that what we're talking about isn't even a very rare case. The first mini-moon discovered in our cosmic neighborhood, 1991 VG, visited us between late 1991 and early 1992. In 2006 RH120 was observed, initially considered an artificial object like space debris. It was confirmed as a mini-moon less than 7 meters in diameter that stayed near Earth for about a year between the summer of 2006 and the following year. In 2020, another celestial body was discovered that remained in orbit around our planet for more than 2 years, becoming the longest-lasting mini-moon observed and confirmed. The availability of new observation systems has allowed for more precise detections over the years, but there have still been some errors that have led to greater caution. In 2002, a new mini-moon was thought to have been identified, but further analysis indicated that what was discovered was most likely space debris. It is believed that the object was the third stage of a Saturn V, the large rocket used in various versions between the late 1960s and early 1970s for the U.S. Apollo lunar program. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. Data collected in recent decades have also allowed for the creation of models and simulations to estimate how many celestial bodies end up in orbit around Earth, even temporarily. Some analyses have indicated that there is probably always at least one celestial body with a maximum diameter of less than a meter around the planet. However, their sizes make direct observation very difficult, so they almost always go unnoticed. The processes that lead to the capture of asteroids in temporary orbits around Earth do not directly depend on size, and therefore nothing is preventing the possibility that an asteroid larger than a meter could be captured and remain in Earth's orbit as a satellite for a certain period. Of course, small asteroids are much more common than large ones, so it is rarer for this capture phenomena to involve large asteroids. However, nothing physically prevents it, apart from the rarity of the phenomena. What speed and mass should an asteroid have to be captured by Earth's gravitational pull and orbit around it without bouncing away or penetrating the atmospheric shield? Mass is completely irrelevant, as with all gravitational processes. The approach speed to Earth should be very low, comparable to or slightly less than Earth's escape velocity. Only then could Earth's gravity hold it in orbit. To become a true mini-moon, an asteroid must come within a relatively low distance from Earth, less than 1.5 million kilometers, and with an equally low speed, about 1 kilometer per second. Only under these conditions can the object be captured by Earth's gravity or at least have its trajectory altered. The day after its discovery, 2024 PT5 reached its closest distance to Earth at about 568,000 kilometers, moving away with a relative speed of 1.37 kilometers per second. The initial conditions seemed promising for a complete capture. However, following its close approach to Earth, its orbit underwent significant gravitational perturbation. The semi-major axis of its orbit increased from 0.97 AU to 1.01 AU, and its orbital inclination increased from less than 1 degree to about 1.5 degrees. All this placed the object in an orbit that until November 25th will keep it between 3.5 and 4 million kilometers from Earth, far from our planet's gravitational clutches. As a result, 2024 PT5 will approach, orbit around our planet, and then leave in the opposite direction from where it entered, but it will not complete an orbit. Is there a way to explain this odd behavior in simple terms? Orbital mechanics is a strange subject. If you have a single object, say a planet, orbiting a star like our Sun, then things are relatively simple. The orbit could be an almost perfect circle, or a more or less elongated ellipse, or a variety of other mathematical shapes. The time it takes to complete one full orbit around the star is called the planet's orbital period, and tends to remain fairly constant. For a circular orbit, the planet's speed remains constant, but if the orbit is an ellipse, the planet speeds up a bit when it's closer to the star and slows down when it's farther away. Now let's suppose there's a second object, like an asteroid, orbiting the star. Let's assume the asteroid has an orbit very similar to the planet's, but slightly more elliptical, so its orbital period is almost exactly the same as the planet's. From our external point of view, we would see both orbiting the star, each completing an orbit at nearly the same time. However, according to Kepler's third law, sometimes the asteroid will move a bit faster than the planet, and sometimes slower, even though its average orbital speed is about the same as the planet's. In practice, when the asteroid moves on a part of its orbit that is just a bit outside the planet's orbit, it slows down and lags behind. When its orbit brings it closer to the star than the planet, it speeds up and moves ahead, and this pattern repeats. This is what an observer on Earth would see, but what if the observer were on the planet's surface? Well, from their stationary reference frame, they would see the asteroid orbiting the planet. However, this would only be an illusion due to the different reference frame. To understand this better, imagine you're driving a car in the middle lane of a three-lane road. Now imagine a car overtakes you on the left, then moves completely to the right lane, where it slows down, falls behind you, and then accelerates to overtake you again on the left. Wouldn't it seem, subjectively, that the car is circling around you? Of course, but someone watching from the side of the road would simply see the two cars overtaking each other along a straight path. In short, objects like 2024 PT5 aren't really moons because they actually orbit the star, not the planet, and they tend to be too far from the planet to be gravitationally bound. They can at most be defined as quasi-satellites or quasi-moons. The trajectory of the small asteroid relative to Earth will be much more complex than the example given. And if I could express it more vividly, I would say that 2024 PT5 will be attracted to our planet like a dry leaf caught and held for a while by the air vortex of a passing car. In simple terms, the second moon of Earth will just be a travel companion that will journey with us a bit closer than usual. Then it will resume its orbit around the sun.